Hello, and welcome back to This Insanity. And this time we have not only the King of the Skies, but the King of Bullshit, Dreadking Rathalos. And no, I am not salty at all. And yes, I have done this many times. This is attempt God knows whatever. I'm basically just losing the plot almost at this point. Long and short of it is, this guy has kicked my ass many times. And I have basically got a script now for what I'm going to have to say to you guys. Yeah, because I've got a bit of setup for this to make this work. Because previously, with the other deviants, I could just run into a quest and not be really prepared for them and still be able to beat them in time. However, the Dread King is just too strong and has too much health for me to be unprepared. So I have a plan. A devious and cunning plan, if I do say so myself. Okay, so let me run it down for you. So first things first, I have to eat for feline weakener. Now if you don't know what that is, that just means that it stops the Rathalos from having increased health, because there is a scaling factor in it from -2 to +2, where 0 is the average. So if you eat for weakener, it ensures that you don't end up with +1 or +2. It doesn't affect the attack or defense of the monster, it just scales down their health. So don't worry, he will still be able to one-shot me very easily, and that's basically every one of his attacks can one-shot me. So the second part of my plan is what I'm currently doing, is to exploit these pitfall traps to try and smash in one of those wings. I've got combines for two more. It's not guaranteed that I'll get two more, because I just don't want to carry around that many combine books and not have everything else that I want. So even though I do have more pitfall traps, I'm not going to rely on the damage that I can get from them. I've done some maths on the damage that I'm doing and the damage output that I need to reach to try and beat him, and I don't actually need those extra two pitfall traps, from what I can work out anyway. So following on from the pitfall trap combines, I've also brought a lot more combines for flash bombs too, because yeah, it's just so easy when the Rathalos rages and he jumps back, you have an immediate opening to use them. So once I've broken one of his wings, that is going to be like the majority of my DPS on this guy. Well, I guess it's more like DPM actually, because I'm not going to be hitting him that often. Whatever. The third and final part of my plan is to really control his attacks, well, as much as I can do anyway. So he does like to do his jumping back, like 360 no-scope firebomb, like directly onto your face whenever you try and approach him from behind. So I just have to be very careful where I position myself when I go for an attack, so that when he does try to do that attack, I can roll towards him and not be hit by it, hopefully. It kind of goes against the grain of what I want to do, because normally I will attack and then roll instantly, and then try and reposition from there. But that was getting me killed no end of times. Because what happens is, obviously you roll, and then you end up on the other side of him, but then your back is facing to him, so when he does fireball you, you've got no way of blocking or reacting to what he's gonna do, so you just die straight away. So instead, I have to sort of delay, so if you see me kind of like not going for an attack, and just sort of sitting there, I'm waiting for him to do an attack so then I can roll after him and not get hit by the fireball, or it's AoE. Oh, and also, I will need to go and kill myself to get supplies, because it will just be much faster than me running all the way back. So if I'm doing really well, and then I just seem to do something really stupid and die for no reason, it's actually not for no reason. I'm dying on purpose. I promise. It's all part of the plan, and I didn't just make a stupid mistake. Alright, so I think that pretty much explains my game plan for this. So hopefully, when you watch it, it'll actually make sense what I'm doing, and I'm not just going to be running around like an utter idiot. I have kind of thought about this. So yeah, I have definitely spoken too much, so I will leave it there. Hopefully see you on the other side of a successful run. Oh shit, son. He's actually limping. Oh yes. Oh my god, I'm actually gonna be able to do it. Oh fuck, that's... Oh my god. Fucking hell, I'm so happy. I was just sort of like gonna wait for him to move area and then just risk it because I'm so close to like timing out now. Oh my god, I'm just so happy. So happy that I finally managed to do it. This has been such a good run. Oh my god, I have failed so many times. I was starting to think that this just was not possible, how I was setting this up. But wow, here we are. We have a guaranteed capture. I've just got to make sure that I don't get like too excited and just jump in there before he's fallen asleep and then just make my life a misery as he just flies over the trap endlessly and taunts me. He's actually asleep. And I'm actually going to do this. This is actually happening. I'm not sure I can actually express just how fucking happy I am and what a relief it is to finally have managed this. Just fucking yes. Fuck you, Rathalos. Just fuck you so much. Oh wow, well, there you go. I've done it. I've managed to fucking do it, finally. I'll go back through all my replays and I'll find out how many have failed prior to this one. And I'll tell you honestly, I'll put it up on like a little notice or something. Oh, wow. Well, there you go. God, I feel exhausted after that, honestly. Just emotionally and mentally exhausted. Okay, I'll just finish it there, I guess. So thank you for watching. And I hope you'll join me again if there's any more after this, if I can bear to do any more. Until next time, live long and rock on, guys. Bye.